His Excellency, the Right Honourable David Johnston.
Now, before the formalities, Louise, it's obvious that you've heard me speak before because you were muzzling me with that hood. Elders, Chief Atlio, Chancellor Mandel, President Nilsen, ladies and gentlemen, and importantly, new graduates. Sharon and I want to thank you for conferring upon us these honorary doctorates of laws. It's such a pleasure to be here with my wife, who's done so much for me, our family, and our country, and I'm so proud to be honored alongside her today, and this is the first time it's a twofer, husband and wife together on this stage for an honor. Yes, she is known as Granny Sunrise, and I am not Grandpa Sunrise because she gets up before the sun does and I do not. I'm Grandpa Buck. Let me congratulate all of our fellow graduates today who've worked so hard to get to this point. And let me refer to Northrop Frye, the most prominent scholar of the English language and critic in the last half of the last century, who at a convocation like this said, "This is one of the four epic events in your life, the other three being your birth, your marriage, and your death. And the difference with this one is it's the only one where you are sufficiently compos mentis to know what's going on. So like your president said, enjoy yourselves." Nous vivons dans un merveilleux pays, un pays où nous sommes libres de chercher à réaliser nos rêves, un pays où chacun de nous a une voix. We live in such a wonderful country, this blessed country, Canada, one where we are free to pursue our dreams, one where each of us has a voice. And let me quote to the graduates my two favorite lines from Shaw. "Some people see things as they are and wonder why. We dream of things that ought to be and ask why not." That's so appropriate for a university. We see things as they are and wonder why, the curiosity which we all have. But the second line is so important. We dream, it's a vision, of things that ought to be, a moral component, and ask why not, that great Canadian sense of let's get on with it. When I was a university president, and I was for 27 wonderful years, I used to tell graduates, as I tell you now, please remember the silent partner whose contributions have made it possible for you to get the quality of education you've received. First of all, that's your family, whom we've acknowledged already in the president's wise words. But let me also refer to the citizens of Canada, all Canadians whose contributions support quality education in their communities. The question of equality of opportunity and excellence too. Can you have both together? Can you see those as mutually reinforcing qualities come together in education? And I think Canada has worked harder at public education than any country we have. But when I refer to the contribution of all Canadians, the taxpayers, when you're going down the street and you see Mr. or Mrs. Everyone, give silent thanks to them for their indirect support, which has helped to make you the person you are. And so the question is, how can you give back to them, back to your country? Well, one answer is simply vote. In every election, school board, municipal, regional, provincial, federal vote, take a position on issues as your own contribution to the community, bearing in mind your community has already invested a great deal in you to make you wiser, more thoughtful, more curious, and able to contribute in your own way. To build a better country, Canadians should take a vested interest in our country and its people by participating fully in our democracy. The history of voter turnout, particularly in the last decade or so, has been abysmal, at or below 50% in most elections and often at the municipal level 20% or so. Of course, there's cynicism. We recognize that. There are those who distrust those in charge at every level, and there are those who even doubt that our democratic institutions can create positive change. Yet there are many more who know more and more that they have the potential and the power to make their voices heard, to create a smarter, more caring nation, a nation of keener minds and kinder hearts. And it's those people who will be in a position to create change, not simply change, but remarkable, outstanding, surprising, lasting, real change, change that spurs our country and the world toward new realities, and brighter horizons. The idea then is to convince everyone to contribute to make their voices heard. And it's vital that we do so. As the Chancellor outlined so eloquently a moment ago, we have so many important issues: climate change, income disparity, quality of education, quality of opportunity, especially with respect to our Aboriginal people, an aging population, globalization of the economy, alternative energy sources, and the responsible development of our natural resources. And these are just a few of the challenges that need your attention and your participation. Democracy, after all, is not just a word, it's a value. It's one that works hand in hand with the freedoms we enjoy and sometimes take for granted. And it's your responsibility to take part in our democracy, to champion it, to give back. To say that you are responsible and that you can solve the woes that afflict our society may be a lot to put on your shoulders. But I do so because I know that young people can handle it. You are resilient, creative, strong-willed, and you bring a fresh perspective wherever you go. We ignore your opinions and ideas and minimize your contributions at our own peril. Of course, there are many ways to participate. Run for office, join a school board, political party, volunteer in your community. Perhaps you will take a different route by challenging our democratic institutions to do better. Letters to the editor or to your elected representatives, discussing issues, signing petitions, engaging in peaceful protest, or advocating for issues you are passionate about. But the least and the most that you can do is vote. I've had the enviable opportunity to travel around this nation and around the world, and I found myself so thankful that we live in such a good country, with people who are working together to make this a smarter, more caring nation. Vous avez déjà commencé à votre parcours à l'extérieur de l'université. Je vous encourage tous à participer à notre démocratie et à décider de construire un meilleur pays. Et je vous invite à joindre votre voix à la mienne pour lutter contre l'apathie des électeurs et contre le manque de sens civique chez les Canadiens. You've already begun your journey outside the university, so I urge you to participate in our democracy and resolve to build a better country, and join in combating voter apathy and a lack of civic engagement among Canadians. In the words of my predecessor, Lord Byng, be as big, with minds as large, and souls as great, as the land in which you live. It's now up to you. Use what you have learned here and continue to make Canada a place we can all be so proud to call home. Merci.